I'm Cate Costa with New Venture Mentor, and this is your weekly dose of entrepreneurship news. First up, we've got another rankings list for you this week. Chief Executive Magazine's annual Best and Worst States list. Pulling in top ranks for the eighth year in a row is Texas, followed by North Carolina, Florida, Tennessee, and Georgia in the top five. Coming in last were California, New York, Illinois, Massachusetts, and Michigan. It's interesting that the three key startup and venture capital hubs, Silicon Valley in California, Silicon Alley in New York, and the Boston-Cambridge area in Massachusetts, continue to draw so much attention despite being rated so poorly by CEOs. According to J.P. Donlan, editor-in-chief of Chief Executive Magazine and ChiefExecutive.net, CEOs tell us that California seems to be doing everything possible to drive businesses from the state. Texas, by contrast, has been welcoming companies and entrepreneurs, particularly in the high-tech arena. That gives Texas a double gold star, since it also took the number two spot in last week's list of most favorable tax environments, and a double downside for California, which was in the bottom 10 on both scales. Florida also performed well with a top 10 ranking on both lists. So, perhaps investors and new entrepreneurs should break free from the same old and start working on building new entrepreneurial ecosystems reflective of the ease of doing business in these various environments. Just a thought. And if you're a brand new entrepreneur and you need help setting up shop in one of these top-ranked states, or anywhere in the country really, consider taking advantage of eMinute's offer to form 500 free corporations for first-time entrepreneurs. If you have not yet incorporated, eMinutes will draft and file the paperwork for you for free, and they'll even pay your filing fee. If you're already incorporated, eMinutes will review your documents. Hit the links below for more information. In other news, according to the Puget Sound Business Journal and a survey by simplyhired.com, new college grads are not interested in looking for jobs at startups. It seems that despite all of the press that entrepreneurship has garnered recently and the gaggle of newly minted millionaire employees of startups, only 4% of graduating students say that working at a startup is their ideal job after graduation. Today's students want job security more than anything else, and they still feel that more mature companies provide more of that than a startup. If you're a soon-to-be college grad, let me know what you think about this trend and tell me what jobs you and your friends are going after. If you're a recent graduate working at a startup, let me know how it's going and whether you think it would be a good choice for other new grads. And if you're a startup CEO, let me know if you're looking to hire new college graduates, how you're recruiting them, and whether you're finding the talent that you need. And finally, just another friendly reminder to go comment on the way the SEC should implement the provisions of the new Jobs Act. The link to the comment submission page is below the video, so make sure that your thoughts are taken into consideration when the SEC decides how the Jobs Act will actually affect all of us. And please remember, the act is passed, the comment period is open, but crowdfunding for equity stakes in a business is still not yet legal. Don't derail your dreams by not paying attention and getting caught up in an illegal offering of securities. Just wait until the Act's provisions go into effect if you need to go the crowdfunding route. That's it for entrepreneurship news this week. We'll see you back here next week for the latest. And don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel and follow me on Twitter for more tips, tricks, and tutorials to help your small business grow.